The CEO of CKN News, Chris K. Ndingwandu, joins me now on Skype to bring us perspective to this development. Chris, it's good to have you join me right now. I hope you're safe where you are. Good morning.
Good now, morning, Mike.
Yes.
I am safe. Thank you very much.
A lot of people have been asking or have been commenting or expecting that the president was going to declare a state of emergency to lock down the country. One way or the other, Nigerians have not seen that yet, but the governors have gone ahead to request for a 14-day or impose a 14-day interstate lockdown. How do you assess that development?
To me, that's a good development. First and foremost, we should commend the governors because although some of them seems to be joining this late, some of them were in denial initially when they started. Some said they were not going to lock up their various states. I remember the Northern governors also saying that they cannot afford to lock down the region for some reasons. But now the reality is dawning on everybody that it's not just the situation happening just in the southern part of Nigeria, but across Nigeria generally. So the result by the governors to be able to lock the state, various interstates, is a good development. Part of the problem we're having now is that despite the lockdown in Lagos, Ogun, and even FCT, we realize that people still sneak in and out of the states to other states presently. The IG of police recently issued a statement where he condemned the action of some transporters who have devised the means of ferrying passengers in the night. Mike, you'd be surprised that people still come from the east, the north, and come into Lagos in the night. So that is a worrisome development. So if the governors have decided on their own to be able to do this, then all well and good. But I still believe that even if they decide, we still have a presidential mandate to that, and the president will be able to issue a statement to that. We can do that. As of this morning, it is 981. Just by yesterday, we have about 108 new cases, and we are not testing enough. So that's the probability that we still have more than what we presently declared about people that currently have this virus. So I think it's a good development for us.
All right, now the authorities are saying that the numbers could even rise as the testing capacity increases. They'll certainly have to enlarge the number of those tested, and certainly the numbers will also rise. Now, apart from locking down states and also interstates, what do you think the governors should be doing in their states? Because when you ask some people still don't believe that there is anything called COVID-19. Some still say it's a scam. There are others who say it's a rich man's disease, and so on. And the reality is upon us, but we still find this expression of doubt here and there.
Yes, Mike, first and foremost, we'll continue our enforcement. That is very key. Then also enlightenment program, both must come, we must be able to do that. If by the latest figure of about 981, and we started close to about 10,000 people, and we have about 981 being positive, that's almost close to 10%. Take that a bit further. For a country of about 200 million people, if you jeopardize that 10% as per the average, you know the number of people that are that may be infected in Nigeria. So the issue is that we continue to enlighten our people that this is not just a joke, that people are dying of it. In the US, the death rate has reached close to 50,000, and that is a country with all the best medical facilities in the world. In the United Kingdom, it's about 15,000 already. Over 30,000 in Spain, in Italy, and these are advanced countries. With the type of healthcare facilities we have here, then if this really hits us, it could be very, very devastating. Then I also look at the issue of enforcement. As I said, our security agencies have not been doing as much as they should. Even if you go to the streets of Lagos, you see transport vehicles flying everywhere. You see people moving on around. And my new one is that despite that, the fact that the government said that people should have, those that are on essential services should have means of identification, do you know that Nigerians have gone ahead to be obtaining fake ID cards to be able to introduce themselves. You see some people claiming to be journalists, whereas they are not journalists. You see some people claiming to be what they are not, and that. So just for them to be able to move around. So this is going to be a very, very big issue. So the state, during the state, one, they have to provide the necessary infrastructure in terms of medical facilities, not just isolation centers. People, we are building isolation centers, but we should be able to build the capacity to be able to make sure that people are well tested.
All
look
right.
at what is happening in Kano.
Okay.
Now, the testing has stopped in Kano, you know that. You know that the testing stopped in Kano a few days ago.
Okay.
And there is rising cases of the virus spreading in Kano. Mm. So I think we need to increase the capacity.
All right. The numbers keep increasing. And in fact, a state like Plateau just got its first case just yesterday. All right. Thank you very much, Chris K. Ningwandu, for your time on the program. It's time for